Hey, what's up, everybody? So I'm going to be doing a routine today with weights and barbell. I've got two 20 kilogram plates on a 15 kilogram bar, so that's 55 kilograms, which probably don't sound like much, but I'm only about 67 or 68 kilograms myself, so bear that in mind. This is going to be really tough. I'm dreading it. But yeah, I mean, I've got the equipment, might as well use it. I love the minimalist routines as well, with just your body and the floor. But I love routines like this also. There's nothing wrong with using equipment if you got it. And these sort of routines, as long as you don't cause yourself an injury, you're gonna definitely make you stronger, pile on a load of muscle. So when you do get back to just those minimalist routines, you'll be feeling a lot lighter and a lot stronger. So I'm going to be doing the routine today is five deadlifts and then into like a hanging squat clean, I suppose, or like a front squat, five of those, and then into five push press or shoulder press, kind of like a thruster, but I'm not going to squat all the way down. Just drive it up through the power of the legs, up above the head. And then I thought 10 burpees, 10 toes to bar, and that'll be around. I've never done this routine. I tend not to practice the routines. I just try them out. If it fails, it fails, whatever. I'll come back to it. But yeah, so I don't know how many rounds I'm going to complete. Let's give it a good shot, eh? All right, let's try this. I have warmed up already, by the way. Kinda. I'm pretty impatient when it comes to warming up, to be honest. I do try. I don't have a lot of time as it is, so I'm just trying to. I just want to get in there and get it done. Right. Gonna take a little minute. It's heavy, man, for me anyway. I've stick some gloves on. It's very damp in here. Hence the
little slip there at the beginning. So I'm only two rounds in, and I can safely say this is the hardest thing that I've done in a while. Harder than any challenge I've done so far. As you can tell by my breathing, am I nearly falling over? Separate the rounds here. Simply don't have the power. This isn't a fashion statement, by the way, with the socks pulled up. This is just as the bar drags along the shins, cuts my skin, so it's just a little layer of protection. Jesus Christ. Three rounds. I've seen some guys doing this sort of exercise and they just throw the bar around like it don't weigh a thing. When I'm watching it, I'm thinking, oh yeah, I could do that. This is a reality check. Squats, a lever, a little breather, five shoulder press. Okay. It's those cleans that do it, man. Okay. That movement. Not used to that. Needs a little work. So this is round four. Just gonna do five rounds. And call an ambulance. Last round coming up. Oh yeah. By the way, Burpees crew, this is a homemade slant board. Great for stretching the legs before doing squats or anything really. Also, getting your knees over your toes doing slant board squat. Suggest you check out, I think his name is Ben Patrick, knees over toes guy, for bulletproofing your knee joints or any joint. He's unorthodox, original. He's saving people from getting knee surgeries and just helping people get to their optimum, their peak fitness and athleticism. I don't know what I'm talking about at the moment. But yeah, check out Knees Over Toes Guy. Build yourself a slant board, especially if you do get any sort of lower back or knee pain during these squats and burpees. It's an easy thing to make. It'll sort you out. Alright. Raises.
Get a bit of blood flow to my hands, eh? Five rounds. I mean, it still stayed very heavy, but it definitely felt better as it went on. It's a cool routine. Something I've definitely got to work on, and I will. And I'll be back to smash that. At least crack it a little bit. I know doing these challenges that we've been doing in this burpee community, some people perform better than others, and everyone's got a really great attitude about it. But it really is a competition with yourself. I can't be in competition with any of you guys because we're not professional athletes. We haven't got managers and nutritionists and I mean, sometimes I get 4 hours, 5 hours sleep a night. Some days my workload is way bigger than others. Some days I haven't eaten properly, or I've had to skip dinner and just eat cereal for dinner. All these things matter, you know? And none of us know what's going on in everyone else's lives.
Some people have kids, some people don't. Some people have hard jobs, some people have easier jobs. Or it's all relative, it's all against yourself. So the main thing is you're pushing yourself to do the best that you can do. And that's mostly a mental game as well, man. Like, our bodies are capable of so much, and our minds often try to stop us from pushing too hard so we don't get injured. Our minds want us to be safe and lazy. But if you can overcome that internal dialogue and create a new dialogue, one that tells you it's okay to keep pushing, you're going to recover fine. You're stronger than you think. Then you can start breaking some barriers, start making some gains. I mean, yeah. Although again, I'm trying to talk a bit more. So that was cool. And I'm about 30 minutes in, 27 minutes in. So I thought I'm just gonna try and go through that Spartan routine one more time. Set the camera up here. Have a go at that Spartan 100 routine from strong positions. I mean, I often do this, open my big mouth and bite off more than I can chew. I've always done that. That's why I get indigestion. But whatever. If I get to 20 and I fail, then that's what it is. But I'm aiming for 100 of these. So what is it? Three pump, and then three jump squats, landing in the squat position. I try to make my squats a little deeper this time for anybody that thought my squats weren't deep enough. It's just when you're doing jump squats, you shouldn't go all the way down, arse to grass. You should just go 90 degree and then a little jump. But anyways, I'll try and go a little deeper to satisfy anybody out there that doubts me. Yeah, the shirt's coming off too. Don't worry, I'm not gonna pose on Instagram or anything. Not that there's anything wrong with that. If that's what people want to do, let them do it. It's just bloody hot. Alright. Nine. 10. 11. Thank you. Bit of a break. Come on. Yeah. Five. Six. 24 minutes. Sorry. Took a lot longer than the first time I did it. But the first time I was pretty fresh. I had done some heavier deadlifts and squats and bench press the day prior. So it's kind of like an active recovery challenge. But this time it was much harder. But I've got a theory. It's like when I did the 500 Navy SEALs. 500 Navy SEALs is definitely really, really tough to do. So I thought if I do 1500 squats as well, it'll make it even tougher. And therefore, in my mind, making me feel like I can do 500 Navy SEALs quite easily because I made it tougher. The same with this challenge. This is a Spartan challenge, it's a tough challenge. So I thought if I kill my legs before I start and do a heavy workout before I start it, it's gonna make it harder. But long term, I think it'll make it easier because in my mind, I've always got, I've done this challenge right after lifting weights, so it can't be that difficult. I mean, I'm not very good at articulating what I mean, but hopefully you understand what I'm trying to say. Basically, make things harder, so therefore they become easier. Yeah, let me know what you think. Oh, and also, does anybody know if I'm, like, how do I get away with playing music while I do workouts? Do I just have to write in the description what the song was and to avoid copyright? I don't know how to do it. But I'd like to start working out with some music occasionally. So if anyone knows how I can do that without copyright issues, if you don't mind, just hit me up in the comment section, let me know. I'll appreciate it. Hit like and subscribe. Have a beautiful day. Peace.